The Harvey recovery process promises to be a long and very expensive one. Americans and businesses everywhere are opening their wallets, but navigating through charities can be challenging, and officials are telling potential donors to stay alert. According to the FBI, Hurricane Katrina's destruction was followed by more than 36,000 complaints to the Fraud Task Force. More than 1,300 people were indicted for Katrina-related crimes by 2009. To help us decipher which charities are the trustworthy ones, let's bring in Larry Lieberman, Chief Operating Officer for Charity Navigator. So here are some of the top local nonprofits in the Houston area from Charity Navigator. Walk us through how a donor can find a safe place to donate their money.
Sure. It's no different. In every sector, consumer advocacy is a full-time job. For more than 15 years, Charity Navigator has been the largest independent evaluator and rater of charities. So during disasters like Harvey, our work at Charity Navigator is particularly valuable to donors because every day our analysts are evaluating the data, both good and bad, to create the ratings we publish on our site. So it's really as simple as a full-time team doing nothing but evaluating organizations so that we publish those results and allow consumers to have access to them.
Tell us about some of the other resources that donors can use and feel reliable.
Sure. The most important thing we tell donors to do is be proactive. Choose a cause they want to support, choose an area they want to support within this crisis, and be specific about the impact they want their work to have. And with their donations, they then can do the research to find organizations that may be more involved in housing, more involved in like the Food Bank of Houston, in feeding, more involved in even caring for the pets that have been abandoned. There are a full breadth.
Okay, so once you've done all that homework and you've donated your money, is there any way to track how that money is specifically used?
Sure. We also encourage people to give monthly and stay in touch with the organizations with whom they are giving, right? This crisis, like many others, isn't going away anytime soon. So it's important for donors to check back in with charities every 3 months or so to see what progress is being done with the money they're giving, and to give them an opportunity to give more, to adjust their donations, and increase their donations if they're so compelled.
Well, you know, sadly, as we know, there are always scammers out there waiting in every situation, no matter what. What are the signs for people to look for to avoid that?
Sure. First and foremost, if you haven't heard of an organization, be suspicious. Okay. But part of doing your research is making sure that the organization you're giving to is a tax-exempt charity, sometimes called a 501c3. And if an organization is in fact a tax-exempt charity, then look deeper to see their financial health and the accountability and transparency practices of their operation.
Back in 2016, Republican Senator Chuck Grassley from Iowa released a study that showed the Red Cross spent $124 million on internal expenses, one quarter of the money donors gave for earthquake relief to Haiti in 2010. How do donors ensure that most of their donations are actually going to the people who are suffering and need it the most?
Sure. You know, Thursday morning's lead editorial in the New York Times was this really provocative and deep evaluation of the practices of the American Red Cross and Charity Navigator's evaluation of their work. So as people look at the American Red Cross, they are by far the largest organization on the ground providing direct relief and direct support. Are they perfect? Absolutely not. Okay. Have they made mistakes along the way? Certainly. Are they committed and taking action to improve the impact of the work they do and the value and the use of every dollar that goes to them? Most definitely. I mean, they're an extraordinary organization.
Well, that is good news. Larry Lieberman, Chief Operating Officer at Charity Navigator. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me.
Still ahead, a smokescreen, unusual activity.